The AYANEO Retro Mini PC AM01 has arrived on IndieGoGo. But what even is a mini PC and should it be on your radar? Let's dig in. The Retro Mini PC comes equipped with Windows 11 Home Edition. Why go with Windows 11 rather than other popular choices like Android or Linux? In short, with Windows 11 you'll be able to play games from Steam, the Epic Game Store, GOG, Xbox and other PC-only platforms. With Android, that can't run Windows games at all, and while Linux can, it's limited to just Steam unless you're willing to get technical. Is Windows 11 perfect? Not by a mile. But if you've ever used a Windows PC before, chances are you'll take to Windows 11 fairly easily. Okay, let's talk specs. The Retro Mini PC comes with the choice of the Ryzen 3 3200U or the Ryzen 7 5700U. For RAM, you have the choice of 8GB, 16GB or 32GB. All of those are DDR4, by the way. For storage, you've got an M.2 2280 PCIe 3.0 SSD that comes in either 256GB, 512GB or 1TB. The important thing to keep in mind with this AYANEO Retro Mini PC is that it isn't designed to be a high-end or even a mid-range system. With the AMD Ryzen 7, you'll be able to play PC games, but most non-indie releases from the last 2 years may struggle to run. You also need to factor RAM into this equation. 8GB will be enough for emulation, but for AAA PC gaming, you're going to need to go with 16 or 32GB. As for the lesser Ryzen 3, I'll treat that strictly as an Indian emulation chipset only. What these specs all come down to is what you want the Retro Mini PC for. If it's low-end AAA gaming at 720p with recent releases pulling in sub 30 frames per second, and high-end emulation like the Switch or Wii U, you want the Ryzen 7 model with as much RAM as you can afford. If you're looking to play classic retro titles like SNES, Genesis or MAME, then the Ryzen 3 model should be more than enough. I've been doing some research to give you an idea of what is and isn't possible on the Retro Mini PC, based on how those Ryzen chips perform in PC hardware. Let's take a standard setup of the Ryzen 7 with 16GB of RAM. On that setup, God of War will run at 720p at 21 frames per second. Cyberpunk at 720p as well runs at around 19 frames per second. Grand Theft Auto 5 at 1080p can manage just about 48 frames per second. And Genshin Impact also at 1080p comes in at 39 frames per second. Moving on to the Ryzen 3 with 8GB of RAM, GTA 5 at 720p runs at around 30 frames per second. Cyberpunk 2077 you're looking at about 10 frames per second. And Red Dead 2 at 720p comes in at around 19 frames per second. Now, before anyone panics, it's worth reiterating the Retro Mini PC isn't being sold as a high-end device. Those chipsets are great at what it's being sold as, you know, an emulation box. The important takeaway from these results is this. It all comes down to what you want to use the Retro Mini PC for, once again. If you want something akin to a Raspberry Pi 4 or 5, then the Ryzen 3 version with 8GB of RAM will be more than enough. It just may struggle with higher-end emulation like Switch and Wii U, and the few PS3 or Xbox 360 games that do work. For 8 and 16-bit games, it'll breeze through, no problem. If, however, you're interested in emulating devices like Wii U, indie games and some lightweight AAA games, then the Ryzen 7 model is definitely the one you should be looking at. As with most of these types of consoles, there's going to be a load of options. With the AYANEO Retro Mini PC, you've got a full set of 7 options available to you, each with different price points. The choice comes down to 3 things, really. What chipset you want, how much RAM you want, and how much storage. In terms of cost, it's also worth noting the sooner you order it, the less it costs. The early bird offer on the Indiegogo page is the cheapest, but they're limited to 100 units. Once they're gone, the standard Indiegogo price will be the next cheapest. The cheapest model comes in at $149, and that includes 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage and the Ryzen 3 chipset, while the most expensive comes in at $459, and that includes the Ryzen 7 chipset with 32GB of RAM and 1TB of storage. Who is the Retro Mini PC for? Let me answer that. It's for gamers who want to emulate older systems at home from within a Windows 11 environment. It's that simple. The device also should double up as a solid home media player and internet browser. Video editing and photo manipulation may be pushing it, but for lightweight PC apps, it should be more than fine. As far as alternatives go, the only real option out there that I'd recommend is the Raspberry Pi 4 or 5, and even then, it's Linux-based most of the time and requires more effort to set up than what AYANEO is offering. You buy it, you plug it in, it works. I'll leave you with this, the bottom line. If you want to play retro games on a device small enough to fit almost anywhere with minimal fuss, the Retro Mini PC from AYANEO is well worth considering. If you want something more high-end, then I consider looking at something like the Steam Deck, Asus ROG Ally, or AYANEO's own high-end gaming handhelds. One of them is sure to fit the bill. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a like, and if you'd like to subscribe, that would be fantastic. Until next time, see ya!